And the king of observational mischief, Michael McIntyre himself, joins us now from London. Oh, there he is.
What an entrance.
I was just unsure if it was you, you know, that's all.
I was just doing what I could with the chair here. It's the big reveal. How are you? It's my favourite programme in Australia.
Hey, Michael, your tour kicks off in 2 months now. Surely there's not a tougher crowd than, like, post-Christmas scathing Brits in midwinter. Like, it's a tricky time to launch, isn't it?
Well, that's why I'm coming to you, because you're so friendly. No, I absolutely love coming to Australia because it's so far that you're so grateful that I've come that I think you laugh harder in the hope that I'll return. I think there's definitely a sense of thanks for coming. Let's make it... Let's be hospitable. It's like I'm a guest. It's like, keep laughing and he might come back. So I really, really enjoy that.
It's great that you enjoy it. We love having you here. Although, can I admit to a little bit of concern about the title? Jet-lagged and jolly. Mm-hmm. Look, jolly is wonderful. Yes. But jet-lagged kind of feels like you're coming up with an excuse for the show being bad before you actually do it.
Quite wrong. Oh. Jet lag is perfect for me because I'm a morning person. So I wake up, I'm very funny between when I've got a coffee on the go in the morning. So between, like, I don't know, I would say 8 and 11 is my peak time. And unfortunately, I always have to gig at, like, 8 p.m, 9 p.m, 10 p.m. But in Australia, that's the perfect time. So when I go there, I never get onto the time zone. I sleep all day. Probably the best show I've ever had in my life was in Melbourne, at the Rod Laver Arena, when I literally slept all day, overslept, people were banging on my door saying, you're on, and I had to get in the car, get out the car, straight on stage holding a coffee, and I was just all over it. So, no, that's why I love it. Jet lag is good for me. It's you hitting me at my peak time, which is the morning.
Good to know.
But that means I sleep all day. I've never seen Australia in the daylight. I don't even know if you have daylight. It might as well be Scandinavia to me.
Perpetually dark. Like your humour.
No, I wouldn't say that. You've not obviously not seen me recently.
I bring the light. Sunny. Well, you know, because you are so attracted to imitation and you're so talented at it, which stereotypical Aussie locals do you like to hang the most on?
Yeah, well, I do have this... I don't even know if it's an issue, but I do accents when I'm around people. And obviously, when I come to Australia, I stay there for, like, almost a month. And I would say that I become Australian. I find it more comfortable. And I'm a happier person. I like the way you talk. I like the... It's quite... I like the pace of it. It's a lot slower than I'm used to speaking. So it makes me quite relaxed. It's quite good for my peace of mind. Do you know what I mean?
It's
and it gives you
good.
More time to think of your next sentence. Do you know what I mean? So, because I'm rabbiting along all the time like this. I'm frantic in London, but over there, I'm just totally chilled. Do you know what I mean? And I actually think... the whole world would be a better place if everyone spoke with an Australian accent. That's my honest opinion. Every time I come to Australia, I don't know if you know, well, you must have flown into Australia yourself, but they question you very firmly on what you're packing. They're very worried about food.
Yes.
So I remember the first time I came, there was a long queue of people, and they just, individually, they just square up to you and go, have you got any food? Have you got any food? And when it got to me, I was like, somebody help this man. He's obviously starving. Do you have anything to give him? I have some chewing gum. If he wants some chewing gum, maybe I could give you... Don't they feed you here? Don't they feed you? That didn't go down well. And there was a full body search.
Oh, hello.
Did they find any food?
They found quite a few sandwiches.
They really don't like dried apricots. They get funny about dried fruit. So don't bring your dried apricots with you, OK?
Yeah, what's wrong with the dried fruit? What damage can that do?
It makes people fart.
OK, it's a flatulence issue. You're trying to keep flatulence.
It's the ozone flatulence layer.
It doesn't deplete the ozone even further.
Michael, obviously, you're one of the biggest comics in the world. I imagine you've had so many crazy offers to experience things and perform for weird people over the years. Do you have one that stands out that you're like, I can't believe I got to do that?
I performed. We have this thing called the Royal Variety here, which is where I actually got my big break, where you perform for royals, because it's the Royal Variety Show. I know you're big fans of the royals over there. I did it 5 times, I think. And the Queen never came to mind. She would always come to the ones in between.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, it was like she was avoiding me, so I never got to actually meet the Queen. But I had Prince Charles every time, and now he's king. So, you know, I've done my groundwork now.
Well, we should say to people that your 2019 tour of Australia sold out in 20 minutes. Ooh. So if you want to catch Michael early next year, you need to book him now. Get onto our website. All the details are there. Michael, it is always a pleasure. Thank you.
I can't wait to be there and become an Australian person for a month in the night.
Nocturnal.
Good time, guaranteed. Yeah.
Thanks, Michael. So good.
Thank you, guys.